Hi there. Thanks for joining me today for what's going to be a little bit of an unusual video. I don't usually talk about what's going on in the world, but today I want to take some time because what's going on is really unusual, and it's particularly impacting people that are already going through a divorce or the people that are just in the initial stages of thinking about it. So the run-up to elections is always a little bit jarring. This happens every 4 years, and if you're wondering if it's normally like this, no, it's not normally like this. This is not normal. This time around is way, way, way outside of normal. The other thing is that there's often a little bit of ambient stress in the air up here in New England around the time of the change in seasons, right? It means colder, darker, shorter days. And people are usually a little bit stressed. This year, add a pandemic to it, after 6+ months of people basically sequestered in their homes, yeah, this is a whole new animal. And if there's already stress in your relationship, all this stuff that's happening around all of us, well, it looms even larger. So I'm gonna give you some advice. Some of it's what I'm doing myself, some of it's what I'm trying to do myself, and some of it's what I've learned from our most successful divorce clients about what they're doing. Okay, first up, avoid the news. I know I have been beating this drum since the beginning of the coronavirus, but it is getting even more urgent now that we're closing in on an election. Look, I am a lawyer, and I'm gonna talk to you as a lawyer right now. President Trump's strategy is chaos. Chaos is the strategy. So if you watch 24-hour news or you watch debates, this chaos, the strategy, is designed to get to you. The good news is that you are 100% in charge of what you watch. You are 100% in charge of whether you go on Facebook and get sad and then upset and then angry and then confused and then heartbroken about the screed that your relative posted. You are in 100% in charge of what you watch, what apps you let be on your phone. I just took it off. I don't have the impulse control to not go to it. I had to take it off. Turn that stuff off. Get your head on straight, play your own game. The way you contribute is by voting. Second, do not use your upset at this election or your understandable exhaustion with coronavirus and being at home and homeschooling and everything you're trying to do as an excuse. Stop eating too much. Stop drinking too much. Stop not going for that walk or that hike or that run. Stop going on Facebook. You are a grown-up person and you are capable and confident and accomplished. And you know that when you are disciplined about taking care of yourself, you will feel better and you are the best version of yourself. You are first, your children are second. You can't do your kids unless you do you. I know that this is hard. I am not perfect. The wine I had last night when I broke my rule and watched a debate did not help. But today, I got on my bike and I ate a salad. Literally every day, each of us get a do-over. Now, I know that I just spent the last few minutes telling you to get off Facebook, and you're almost certainly watching this on Facebook. Thank you. Thank you for clicking on this. I want to give you a little bit of a sense of how things are going and how we can actually help you do this stuff and get back in control. The courts are working. It's different. We're online. We're working. People are getting divorced. People are negotiating. People are working out problems. People are moving on to the lives they really want to live. Don't let this stuff be an excuse. Let us help you get over to the other side.